Guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video I will be reacting to episodes 9 and 10 of Minami Kai. So let's go ahead and get started with episode 9 in 3, 2, 1, go. That is loud. Look, you started and suck. Why is she close to her like that? Oh my god. Cannot wait to see what the context of that is. Have a good day. So, what else do you do? Kinda, you still jealous, honey? Yeah. You could just sit and watch TV. Literally me on my day off, but then I still have to record. I mean, you still could. Keiko doesn't even know what you're talking about, babe. I hope she doesn't eat that whole cake by herself. Dumb. Yeah, there are some women who have mustaches and stuff, but that's mainly our arms and our legs, maybe other places too, but Kinda no. Girl. You're still a baka, babe. Oh, poor baby. She's just so sleepy that she was moving. Oh, God. So that is the context of that. Okay. These two are never gonna get any sleep. It is 1 in the morning. Or no, it had no three. It had to be 3:10. Orange juice sounds good. These two idiots. Y'all really doing this again? Oh my God. A 10,000 word report. Oh my God. Yeah, you really sick, baby. Oh my God. I it. I can't do it. That's what you get. Chiaki. You feel better? No, you got sick. Oh. Girl. It's too tight. What exactly did you just say, child? Girl, what the hell? Right? I mean, you need to stop eating sweet things. I mean, like, in moderation, though. Kana, I don't know, baby. That quick.
Gladly.
How she leak all that in like a second? Don't even know what the heck to say about this episode. But moral of the end of the day, number one, if you ever make pie for your oldest sister, even though your middle sister is, well, nope, your yeah, your middle sister, because the sec because Kana is the second oldest. Literally, when you're done, put that ish in the fridge so that you know your older sister, your older brother, whoever, your parent come in and be like, oh snap, like somebody made this for me. Booyah. I'm eating it. It's mine. That's like how it's been so many years since my mom has made this particular cake and such. And I was at this party that we had. I had a couple of bites and I told a kid, I was like, go put this in the fridge for me. I'm gonna have it for later. And then the next morning I wanted it and it wasn't there. Somebody ate my cake. I am still pissed about that fucking cake in 2024. Issa, my mom's like, no, it's okay, Nija. Get over it. No, I will never get over that. I wanted that cake. I wanted the cake. It was good and yummy. It was a strawberry whipped cream cake, and somebody ate my fucking cake. And I never found out who. Until this day, I still don't even know who ate my cake. But somebody ate my cake. Moral of the story is, end of the day, you always get revenge on somebody who ate your shit. Don't eat anybody's shit. Don't drink anybody's shit. Don't do that. If you do, you replace it. Always replace it. But can we talk about Connor real quick? When she was sick in the dream that she was having, girl. And then because she got mad at Chiaki, she decided to keep her and Chiaki up until the wee hours of the morning, into the night, and then they go to sleep. And then it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and they're like, "Oh shit! Like, what happened?" Literally, when you're with your friends and you're like, yeah, we're gonna stay up tonight, and you all go to bed like super early. Or like a couple of you go to bed super early, and then you wake up, and or you're the only one up, so then you go to sleep, but then you wake up like a few hours later, and you're just like, I can't. Go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for episode 10. Okay, episode 10 in 3, 2, 1, go. Chiaki. Well, I know we're talking about the blue-haired one, but the brown-haired one literally looked like her. Okay. Oh, dang. But you were the one who pushed him. You sure? Exactly. Makoto. You can't cut that. Did you boil the egg? Chiaki. Oh, this girl. I mean, you asked for it. I mean, yeah. What? Yeah. I know, 'cause even. Yeah. No, don't say it. No, oh my God. No. He's pretending to be a girl. Oh my. I wonder how that's gonna go. Makoto, oh my God. Yeah. Right. Oh. Yeah. Ta-da! The accessories. Hey, at least Makoto freaking tried. You got you got the top and the bottom now, but like his hair. You know how like when some people get dressed in the dark? That's what that was for him. And you gotta feel bad for him because, like, no matter what, he finally wants to come back out and being just himself, a male, Makoto, and literally Haruka and Chiaki are like, oh, you just like drag. That poor kid. He gonna have to live a double life for the rest of his life, man. Because, like, oh my god, this poor child, he's never going to have a time where he's going to be able to be like, oh my god, it was me the whole entire time. I would only say maybe when the series is almost over. Episode. Toma, she's interesting. She a little cutie. I love the fact that, you know, she's going with the situation of Makoto. But yeah, they're super cute. Our little family has gotten even bigger and stuff, and it's adorable. Like, oh my god, stop it. Oh, is it just gonna be a whole episode about her? I mean, what which would be really interesting, don't get me wrong, because the fact is like we barely really know that much about her. She's just the type of person who is literally like she can considers herself both male and female, which is very interesting because of the fact is with her short hair and looking at her, distinguishing whether she wears like shorts or jeans, pants, whatever type, like automatically looking at her, you're like, oh, okay, yeah, you a boy. Because I was thinking that too immediately when I saw her at first, before they panned out and you saw the skirt, and you were like, oh, okay. But there are some guys who do like to wear skirts just as much as some girls like to wear, you know, it's like, okay, you know, like SMT5 when that came out, I think a year after like COVID was, you know, still chilling out and stuff. And I watched I didn't finish the stream because I think she stopped playing at a moment. But from what I did hear, there were some students in that game wearing the male uniform and stuff. And so I thought that was pretty cool. I mean, they're just like with Momiji and Fruits Basket. Momiji was never really into wearing just pants and stuff. He wanted to wear the girls' uniform because the girls' uniform was cute. Then when he got older, that's when he started wearing the male uniform. And then, you know, everybody was taken back, but like, who the heck is this? And it's just the cute baby boy Momiji, except he's older and he looks more cooler. And it's just like, oh my God, like, look at you. You're not a boy anymore. You a man. Oh my God. But other than that, guys, that was my reaction to episodes 9 and 10 of Minami K. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons and next Monday for everybody else for the final 3 episodes of the first season of Minami K. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.